Are some artificial sweeteners better than others? Specifically, you know, what are the benefits or the effects of saccharin or glycerin or other artificial sweeteners like that?
So artificial sweeteners, there are many different categories, if you will. There's sugar, alcohols, and then there's what we call the saccharin. These are the chemically created non-nutritive sweeteners. And so let's talk about sugar alcohols first. So sugar alcohols are endinolol. You can always kind of pick them up on a food label. Xylitol, erythritol, mannitol, sorbitol. Those are all examples of sugar alcohols. And they can all actually impact blood sugar a little bit differently. And so it's important if you're trying out a new sugar alcohol that you check your blood sugar to see what the reaction is for you. But the ones that tend to have the least impact by far on blood sugar, which is key here, are going to be xylitol and potentially erythritol. Now with sugar alcohols, especially in higher doses, people can tend to have some GI issues. So that's another thing to keep in mind as well. So experiment with them when it comes to your blood sugar and your individual tolerance of them. But we tend to recommend a lot of the sugar alcohols overall because of that. And actually, I mean, xylitol, let's take a quick look at xylitol itself. And that is one of the interesting things that people don't realize is right now, everybody who's watching this, Catherine and I, we're making xylitol right now. Our bodies make xylitol. So again, what we're doing is we're ingesting something that we're also making. And so that's one of the reasons that we recommend that. Our bodies are used to that. Xylitol is found, erythritol to a lesser degree, naturally in fruits and even vegetables. So again, that's high on our recommendation list, but everybody needs to check out their individual tolerance of them. Now, the non-nutritive sweeteners, those are ones that have no calories, and they don't by themselves have an impact on blood sugar. And that's been shown in multiple studies. So let's take a look at Splenda, for example. Splenda doesn't, over a patient population, increase blood sugar. Once again, I'll always say, check your own individual blood sugar, but it tends to not have an impact. That being said, it's a chemically created compound. So if you're using something like Splenda, I would use it sparingly. And what you'll notice with these non-nutritive sweeteners is that in their liquid form, it'll say no carbohydrates, no calories. But when you get them in their powdered form, that's a different story. Why? Because they've had to add something called bulking agents, which are carbohydrates, to make them powdery so that you can use them, for example, in baking recipes. So there's a big difference between the liquid forms of these and the powdered forms. And one other sweetener that I'd like to draw attention to that is a non-nutritive sweetener, but is a little bit different, is stevia. So stevia is just from a stevia plant. In other words, it's not chemically created. Now, that being said, stevia is available under many different names. And some of these, the stevia leaves, are highly processed and some aren't. So a good idea is if you're choosing stevia, you want to take a look and research what brand that you're buying so that you can get the least processed stevia. Or if you want to be completely natural about it, grow some stevia. Now, stevia grown and utilized straight from the plant can have a little bit of licorice taste to it. Some people really enjoy it, and for some people it makes it a little less tolerable. So those are my comments about sweeteners. Sugar alcohols, we put them into non-nutritive sweeteners, but the non-nutritive sweeteners are different in a liquid form than they are in a powdered form. And always, when introducing any kind of sweetener, check your blood sugar.